Before I start my presentation, I would like to touch one topic, reliability. Because during my initial days in Sungrow, even in India when Sungrow entered, everybody was asking whether this company product are reliable or not. So in my opinion, there are four major parameters. There may be some other parameters also, but four major parameters in my opinion are, which decides whether company is reliable or not, are: first one is the growth, whether company product or company is growing or it is at saturation phase or it is going like this. Second parameter is the profit, whether company financial situation, how is the company financial situation, whether it is making profits like this or like this. Third point is the technology. Every company always believes that they should invent, they should innovate so that to survive in the market. So technology and that innovation is also one of the major parameter. If any company is doing innovation, then it will survive in the market. Otherwise, we have seen few companies in recent years which has become dead because they were not innovating at all. And fourth parameter is the reach, whether company or that product is limited to a specific region or whether it is has a global reach. So these four parameters I'll be covering in this slides also. You can interlink it with Sungrow so that you can decide whether Sungrow or Sungrow products are reliable or not. So in this next 10 minutes presentation, I'll be covering how Sungrow started and how it grown up globally and how it grown up in India in last 2 years span. And we'll be covering that all these four parameters which we discussed. So based on that, I'll leave decision in your hand whether you should take a call that whether this company is reliable or not. So starting with the this company was actually started by a professor of Hafei University, and gradually this company started growing, and there was a time when Sungrow was asked to supply inverters for one of the major project in China powering the rural areas. So in 2002 that project was executed, and after that 2011 company got listed in Shenzhen Stock Exchange. So it's a listed company in China. And 2016 Sungrow put up a new factory in association with Samsung SDI. So we are having one storage inverter plant in Hefei, China. So this is these are the manufacturing capabilities of Sungrow. Like in 2013, we were having a plant capacity of 1 gigawatt per month. And in 2016, it grown up to 1.5 gigawatt per month. And in 2017, now we have a capacity of 3 gigawatt per month. So from the manufacturing point of view, you can take idea that how big this company is, how manufacturing setup we have in that location. And we also believe in green production. That's why we have put up a solar PV plant, rooftop plant over the factory. Its capacity is 3.4 megawatt, as you can see in the pictures also. So this part is very important, as I talked initially about the reliability. So you can see the exponential growth of the company in terms of shipment as well as in terms of revenue. Company has done exponential growth along with some good profitable margins. It's a listed company, so it's an open book. So you can see it's having a regular, stable, profitable margins it is earning. Along with this, in the last year, 2016, okay. In 2016, there was a shipment of 11.1 gigawatt which Sungrow has done globally. And in this year, till the time period which is mentioned in the slide, we have surpassed that figure. That is around 10.8 gigawatt. So still a couple of months are remain. So we are expecting that around 15 gigawatt figure we are going to touch this year, this financial year. And coming to that market share, Sungrow has a very good market share globally as well as in China. And we are very proud that we are well accepted in Europe also, like countries who believes always in quality. So we are, our product is very well accepted by Germany. So we have almost 25% market share there. So these are the major background of the company. Now coming to the innovation, that technology, because this company, we always believe that Sungrow is a technology driven company. We are among the top two inverter manufacturer suppliers who are having a so big R&D team. 30% of the total employees are invested in Sungrow R&D. And in a single year, we have filed these around 129 patents we have filed in a single year, and total accumulated patents are more than 550, 545 around that. So now we have that R&D team. Now, whether that setup is there so that R&D team can work and do some innovations, so for that, you can see that we have in-house test laboratories and training testing center also inside that company. So all the major latest testing equipments we have in our factory, as you can see in the pictures also, and all the setups has been approved by major testing laboratories like that CNS, all major companies, CNS, UV. So these are some of the pictures you can see, testing equipments which we have in our factory. So again, is the all the certifications, because Sungrow is a company who is providing products globally. So we are complying all the major certifications which are required to supply a product in a particular country. So presence, I was talking about the reliability. That one point was whether how reach of the company is, whether it is limited to a specific region, it is limited to only for Sungrow, if it is limited to China only, or it has a global presence. So as you can see from this picture that we have a global presence. We are doing business not only in China, we are doing very good business across the globe. So we have our offices across the globe, as you can see in the pictures also. And in India, we just started two, three years before. And Sungrow is, I think, one of the company who has supplied this much figure, that 49 gigawatt plus inverters globally. These are some of the major global customers we have in our customer portfolio, like Light Source, IBC Solar, Juvi, Enerpark, all major customers we have in customer portfolio. Now these are some of the reference pictures which are shown here. For utility scale, we have supplied in these all major countries, if you'll see. So these are the commercial commissioning which has been done by Sungrow or by some developer, but product was used was Sungrow. Now coming to the residential, Sungrow is in residential market also. In India, we have not yet started that business residential, but in Australia, we are very strong. In China, we are very strong. Even in Germany also, we are supplying some residential inverters, small rating inverters. So we are into, as mentioned in my initial slide, that we have some tie-up with Samsung, where Samsung is providing the lithium-ion batteries. They are manufacturing the batteries in our campus. We have two offices together where we are providing the electronics part and Samsung is making the batteries. So we are providing the complete solution, that is the storage solution. So we have whatever we have supplied globally is as shown in the pictures. So now product is done, reliability, all those parameters are done. Now coming to the major thing which can lead any company to survive for a longer period is the service. So Sungrow is not only having offices, sales offices, we have wide service network also. So all the orange marked places you can see, we have our offices there. We are providing standard 5 years warranty, which can be extended up to 25 years. And we are organizing some technical seminars also, training at customer end also. Recently, last week, we had a technical seminar in Delhi. And now upcoming event is in Kolkata. Now, this is the main that how Sungrow started. I'll discuss in this slide, I would like to discuss the 2 to 3 years before. There was a scenario when very few people were aware of about the Sungrow brand. And at that time, there was one Chinese guy, Luke Liu. Many people know about him, Luke Liu. He was a guy who was continuously traveling across the India. He was meeting all the major developers, EPCs company, no matter small or big. And he was meeting some channel partners also. And I still remember during my initial days in Sungrow, one customer asked him that, where do you stay? So his answer was Indigo Flight. It was very surprising because he was continuously traveling. So there was no particular location he was based out at. So he said Indigo flight is my base location. So you can see the hard work he has done. And initially the team who have joined, initial members, have done a lot of hard work due to which today we have reached at this figure. So in the initial last 2-3 years, that was a struggling phase. After that, luckily we were accepted by all major developers and EPC companies. And now we have a team of around 50 people in India, including service engineers, HR, and now we have complete operation team also. And in the next year, we are planning to put up a factory also here in India, in Karnataka, near Bangalore. So this is the growth story about the company, Sungrow in India. So we have our offices in India, in Gurgaon. We have our corporate office in Bangalore. We have one, and as well as in Mumbai, we have one office. So these are the product offerings which we have for Indian market, like starting from utility scale central inverters. We are offering indoor inverter 500 kilowatt, 630 kilowatt in 1000 volt, as well as we are offering container solutions 1000 volt as well as 1500 volt. So I still remember, I would like to discuss one more point here. I still remember 1 year before, everybody was just using indoor inverters. So Sungrow was the one company, there was container solution also, but nobody was doing some innovation inside that container. So Sungrow was the one company that providing that container solution in India market with all complete turnkey solution as a turnkey solution, which was having ACDB panel, data logger, everything inside that container. So that innovation was done by Sungrow, and gradually now everyone started following that. So in string inverters, we are again having small range also, but for Indian market, we are giving only 33 kilowatt, 50, 60, and another upcoming products 10 kilowatt, 50, 80 kilowatt, and 125 kilowatt in 1500 volt. As well as in storage, as mentioned, we have that PC is starting from 100 kilowatt, it goes up to 1 megawatt. So in terms of the presence, Sungrow has commissioned this project till June 2017, and now we are very close to 2 gigawatt. So you can see our products are in all the regions, whether it is hot in Rajasthan, these container solution has been accepted by all the environment. So these are some of the reference picture for Indian projects which has been commissioned. 65 megawatt Madurai, Pokhran, Bhadla, all the major, these are some of the pictures. This is the 1 megawatt storage plant which we have commissioned just adjacent to this Radisson Blu Hotel, where we have supplied this 1 megawatt storage inverters. So again, all the central inverters we have done. So talking about the service network, we are expanding very aggressively in service. The marks which are mentioned in the Indian map are the hubs where we are creating some spare storage also. So we have, at this moment, we have more than 30 engineers who are based out at different locations, as well as have some resident engineers who are very near to the major PV plants which has been commissioned so far. So these are the list of some of our reputed Indian customers to whom we have supplied our inverters. All major reputed EPC and developers are there. So this is also one of the major thing which Sungrow is planning. We, as I told you, that we are planning 1 3 gigawatt annual capacity factory in Karnataka in the next year. This is our short term goal. So for long term, I would say that we are also planning to create 1 knowledge hub as well as the R&D center in India. So this is about the Sungrow, and if there is any question related to Sungrow, our team is here, so we are there to support you. Thank you.